Lee, so such a pleasure to meet you. Looking forward to chatting with you today about this amazing series that we have our fingers absolutely crossed for, doing some amazing things this awards season.
Thank you.
So you're the showrunner amongst many other roles that you've played behind the scenes on this project. I want to talk about that bold move that you made, picking up that telephone and contacting Apple, letting them know, listen, I want first dibs on this series. Take me back to that moment, and what was it that came over you to make you just take that initiative?
Yeah, I mean, the book was something that Aggregate with Jason Bateman and Michael Costigan had with Brie Larson, and I read it later, and I flipped for it. I thought the writing was incredible. Bonnie Garmus has just told such a beautiful story. I was so moved. I was laughing. My wife and I were kind of reading the book back and forth to one another, and I have had a relationship at Apple for a long time now, and I just started talking to them about what I wanted to do next, and they were looking for a writer for the show, and it just fit. And I think part of it too was I was a recent father, and so much of this story is about parenthood, and particularly mothers, and talking so much to my friends that were all kind of new mothers, and my wife at the time, and I just so much of that part of the story really resonated for me.
What was it like collaborating with Apple in particular with this series?
I mean, Apple. I've been working with Apple for 5 years. I could not think of better creative partners, top to bottom. The executives there are ambitious and thoughtful, and just really, you know, they've allowed me to have a tremendous amount of freedom, and also the collaboration with them has kind of generated these things that I'm incredibly proud of. So I have the best things to say about them.
So of course we're going to talk about Bonnie, because I'm very interested to hear, like, what did that collaboration process look like translating this book onto the screen? Like, what were some of the steps taken along that entire journey?
Yeah, I mean, you know, Bonnie's book has turned into a global phenomenon. So Bonnie is just traveling the world, you know, kind of feeling all the love from all of the fans everywhere. So we were, you know, we spoke early on. I kind of laid out some of my thoughts on some of the changes I was potentially going to make. And then ultimately we just ran with it. We were kind of racing the entire time, and, you know, we just had a blast making it. And so, you know, Brie was really, you know, my main collaborator on the show. And, you know, the sensibilities of the book were something, and the tone was something we really wanted to capture. And this beautiful love story, and so many of the themes that she captured in the book, we really wanted to do justice to it on screen.
And also, speaking of those many themes, obviously there were so many different layers involved with this entire project. I mean, from suicide, sexism, racism, gender inequality, love, grief, loss, the list goes on. What was it like for you as a showrunner, as a writer, to peel back all of those many layers?
You know, the conversations that I had with all of my partners on this, we told a lot of personal stories. We talked about experiencing grief, and we talked about suicide. We talked about first loves. We talked about kind of, you know, lowering barriers so that you can feel connected to people. We had an amazing consultant, Dr. Shamel Bell from Harvard, that we talked a lot about the Sugar Hill neighborhood and what it was like for this, you know, kind of upper middle class Black community to, you know, kind of fighting against, you know, the government, you know, that was just trying to infringe on their civil liberties. And so all of those things, we really wanted the show, and I felt it so much when I read the book, to kind of feel like the sum of the human experience. And so they're not every character, you know, characters are flawed. They make mistakes. They try to do better. And it was really about kind of, and we did it behind the camera, but it was really about kind of, it takes a village. Yeah. And all these people kind of come together, and it in some ways becomes a found family.
That. And it's so interesting, particularly as it relates to the Sugar Hill community. I know that Asia once mentioned that prior to saying yes to this role as Harriet, she was not, you know, very knowledgeable about that particular community. So it was quite interesting to hear that come from her. And of course, speaking of Asia, there were a couple of tweaks made with her role,
were
Harriet.
There?
Yeah. So I want you to talk to me about some of the changes that you made, particularly with Harriet's role, and what was that aha moment for you to say, I think I want to change some things up a little bit?
Yeah, you know, there was no agenda. So much of being a showrunner and being a writer and being a producer is you have to kind of adapt as things happen. And you see an actress like Asia Naomi King, And selfishly, I was like, wait, she's going to have to share lines with somebody else because we haven't cast the Harriet role yet. And so we started talking about what if we started making those bigger changes and made kind of aged down Harriet and made her this, you know, kind of younger, you know, mother with a, you know, a husband who's away, who's raising two kids on her own, who's also kind of, you know, starting her legal career and really fighting for kind of the, fighting to protect her neighborhood, and seeing Elizabeth and Harriet as these two kind of unlikely friends that both are struggling in their ways, you know, Elizabeth kind of fighting against sexism in the workplace, but Harriet really fighting for survival. I just thought the juxtaposition of that was really interesting. And the idea of Asia and Bree kind of doing scenes together, I was just like, I need more of it. I need more of it. And so I really didn't want to cast anyone else and then have the prospect of having Asia have less screen time. And that was kind of the calculation of it.
I love that. And before I let you go, speaking of characters, Mr. 630 himself. Very, very interesting and unique twist added to this series, with basically dedicating an entire episode to the dog, speaking from the animal's perspective. What role did you play in that overall, like, creative process and when it came to switching things up a bit in that area?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the book told, you know, the perspective was often told from the dog's perspective, and to do that in series would be really difficult logistically, and mm-hmm. having a dog, you know, I think in the book the dog knows, you know, has a vocabulary of thousands of words, and that would be very hard to translate. And so it really felt like I wanted every episode to kind of stand on its own, where you immediately knew, oh, this is the one that's this is the one that's that. And telling a story of grief from the perspective of a dog who felt tremendous amount of guilt. He felt like he was the cause of the accident. And hearing that perspective that sometimes you aren't able to articulate, or if a character were to say it, it feels maybe too confessional, or who are they kind of saying that to? But having the dog really struggle with it, and you know, as anyone who's kind of grappled with grief, it's like you're trying to find connections with people. You're trying to, you want to be alone sometimes. You need a hug. You want to hug somebody else.
Yes.
And so seeing that from the dog and kind of lacking the vocabulary and not being able to access Elizabeth during that time felt really, felt like an interesting way to approach that. And something that we spent a lot of time in the writer's room, a lot of tears were shed.
Yes. And as we wrapped, did you give yourself a great big pat on the back for a job well done once this project came to a close? Like, some of the goals that you set out and that you intended to lay out working on this project, do you feel like you accomplished everything that you wanted to accomplish in your position? As I look at the big, great smile.
Sure, no. No, I was thinking, like, all I'm thinking about is, like, oh, God, what am I doing next? What's happening tomorrow? No, but I'm so incredibly proud of the show. It's truly one of the joys of my career. And I didn't know Bree before I started on this. We become close friends. Asia, Lewis, Michael Costigan, you know, Louis Shore, everyone. Like, it was just, it really, to pull something like this off and the ambition that we had from the beginning, it does take a village. And I worked with the best collaborators around. And so everything that we wanted, every kind of crazy idea that we tried to pull off, you need the people around you to kind of say, like, all right, let's figure this out, or to challenge you and say, well, what if we do this, or I don't agree with that. And there was just such a healthy debate, and everyone knew what the beauty of the book was, and everyone wanted to honor it. And I think that it just caused everyone to work harder than they ever had before. But I think that everyone felt like they were kind of part of something really special.
Very, very special.
Thank
I'm very
you so
hopeful
much.
For you guys this award
Thank
season.
You. Tell
congratulations.
Your friends.
Oh, my friends, my cousins.
Yeah, tell your
my
cousins.
My parents, everybody.
Yeah, I need your cousins here. Yeah.
Listen, congratulations
Thank
so,
you so much,
Lee. Such a pleasure chatting with you.
Yeah, you too. Thank you. All right.